the millions paid every year to officials of all sorts whose function is to maintain the rights of minorities, the right, that is, of a few rich men, to manipulate the economic activities of the nation. The millions spent on judges, prisons, policemen, and all the paraphernalia of so-called justice, spent to no purpose. Because we know that every alleviation, however slight, of the wretchedness of our great cities is followed by a very considerable diminution of crime. Lastly, the millions spent on propagating pernicious doctrines by means of the press and news, cooked in the interest of this or that party, of this politician or of that company of exploiters. But over and above this, we must take into account all the labor that goes to sheer waste in keeping up the stables, the kennels, and the retinue of the rich, for instance, in pandering to the caprices of society and to the depraved tastes of the fashionable mob, in forcing the consumer on the one hand to buy what he does not need, or foistering an inferior article upon him by means of puffery, and in producing, on the other hand, wares which are absolutely injurious, but profitable to the manufacturer. What is squandered in this manner would be enough to double our real wealth, or so to plenish our mills and factories with machinery that they would soon flood the shops with all that is now lacking to 2/3 of the nation. Under our present system, a full quarter of the producers in every nation are forced to be idle for 3 or 4 months in the year, and the labor of another quarter, if not of the half, has no better results than the amusement of the rich or the exploitation of the public. This, if we consider on the one hand the rapidity with which civilized nations augment their powers of production, and on the other hand the limits set to that production, be it directly or indirectly, by existing conditions, one cannot but conclude that an economic system a trifle more enlightened would permit them to heap up in a few years so many useful products that they would be constrained to cry, "Enough! We have enough coal and bread and raiment. Let us rest and consider how best to use our powers, how best to employ our leisure."